Hi, I'm Justin Channel. I'm the marketing specialist here at Sucuri, and I'm here with our webinar on our Hacked Website Research Report. In this webinar, I'll share with you the key takeaways from our 2019 trend report, such as statistics, trends, and predictions. This is gonna be a pretty basic overview, so don't be too scared if you're not too technical. We're gonna keep it easy so anyone can understand, whether you're a novice or an expert. Here at Sucuri, we process terabytes upon terabytes of data. It's collected by our cleanup process, web application firewall blocks, site check, scan results, and our honeypot network. Our research team correlates all this data so we can understand the landscape and provide this information back to you. Oh, and just a quick disclaimer. All data is collected following GDPR, CCPA, and any other privacy law guideline. No personally identifiable information is stored on those logs. Break for a coffee sip. Malware family distribution is dynamic. Like any ecosystem, even the smallest change in any of its agents can affect how it will behave. For example, in the 2018 report, we found backdoors were the most present of threats, followed by malware and SEO spam. This year, however, SEO spam leaped two positions into the first place. In this case, the ecosystem change was a noticeable increase in spam attacks on databases and no backdoors present. This may point to SQL injection attacks rather than a full site compromise. Spam is known to be a volume business. To make more money, attackers need to make more active campaigns. That's the main reason why you receive so many different types of spam content on every single site. We track an average of 12 different campaigns on a single website, and most of the time it's related to pharmaceuticals, but like fashion-related spam and pornography are also pretty common. The biggest difference we've been noticing in this landscape is the volume of spam detected on compromised databases. This infection chain was the main reason behind SEO spam taking that top spot. Now, the impact of having SEO spam present on a website may seem harmful compared to, say, an exploit kit, for example. Now, that's something that will harm your website visitors. But SEO spam, on the other hand, will cause harm to your website's reputation, and that includes search engines and the visitors. I'm sure many of you have stopped in your tracks and hit the back button when you brought up shady spam on a website you're trying to visit. Bad actors can use a lot of techniques to hide the spam content too. For example, there are methods that will only be noticed by search engines. So regular visitors aren't going to see the content, but it will be there in the search results from Google and when clicked through. A really simple method is to use CSS and JavaScript to hide content and links. For example, like you could hide white spam text in the white space of a design so it's not really noticeable. Now, getting back to backdoors, the name is self-explanatory. Backdoors are points of entry that a bad actor will leave installed to reinfect a site. In 2019, we found backdoors in 47% of all websites we scanned. We split them into different types like uploaders, remote code execution, and web shells. Each one represents a specific function or method that allows attackers to maintain access to the compromised website. Backdoors like web shells can be easily spotted because they're a big single file left around the system. Chances are that you remove some of them by accident just by updating your CMS or plugins or anything else. But still, there are many different ways for bad actors to hide backdoors, and some of them aren't as easy to spot. To get a bit more in depth with backdoors, let's look at uploaders. They were the most popular type of backdoor we found in 2019. The main purpose of uploaders is, again, kind of self-explanatory, to allow bad actors to upload to a compromised website. This type of backdoor can be used to draw up other malicious files for further attacks to other websites or even your visitors. Remote code execution backdoors allow bad actors to execute code on a website by knowing the right parameters. It can be obfuscated and noisy, like the screenshot you're seeing on this slide, but it can also be as simple as a single line of code with less than 20 bytes. It's small, simple, and can be hidden anywhere. Now, web shells are the opposite of small and simple remote code execution backdoors. They are complex and allow bad actors to perform a series of actions on the website. That includes copying, editing, and deleting files to accessing the database to run PHP code. Anything is possible with those tools, and there are several famous web shells, and you can find out more about them in our blog post and lab notes. So another big takeaway we found involved CMS updates. More than half of the websites we worked on in 2019 were outdated at the point of infection. This number kept the same from our 2018 analysis. Other plugins with known vulnerabilities were tracked as well. If you follow our blogs, you were updated with our advisories on tools for vulnerabilities. Also, the web application firewall uses virtual patching. This allows for using outdated software, but preventing the vulnerability on the firewall. This is good for legacy sites or just to help buy a bit more time to update what is needed. Now, speaking about attacks in general, our web application firewall blocked more than 170 million attack attempts in 2019. Our firewall rules successfully blocked brute force attacks performed by bad bots, virtually patched every vulnerability we tracked, and protected against common attacks like cross-site scripting, secret injections, and remote code execution. Now, the most popular attack was brute force, and it's understandable. You hear news all the time related to leaked credentials. Those attacks have made password dictionaries bigger and bigger. In second place is attacks. Those are related to customized rules in our WAF. That's an indicator that our customer base is not using our default settings, but instead configuring the WAF to make it a little more restricted. So congratulations, everybody. Good job. In 2019, we noticed a drop on the number of websites compromised with crypto miner software. This downward trend was related to both financial and support aspects. Most notably, CoinHive, which was one of the most popular miners, shut down its operations in the first quarter of last year. We also found that most websites that were infected with credit card skimmers were reinfected at some point during the year, even with different malware. Reinfections can happen a lot of different ways. Sometimes it's by exploiting the vulnerability over and over again, or by using leaked credentials that weren't changed. Also, misconfigured hosting, or what we call website cross-contamination, can be a factor. An example would be another website on your server is getting hacked, and that ends up affecting your website. Now, detecting and mitigating infection is essential, but keeping the website safe afterwards is also crucial. And it's a two-way street between us and our customers. So we have our mantra at the end of our malware cleanups, and it's change your passwords, update your software, and configure the firewall. That's there to help keep you safe. We will always have the most updated tech and block attacks. We'll back up your site and remove any malware that gets through, but you're always gonna be the best person to know what's going on with your site. You'll be the best one to know if there are any suspicious users, if any plugins or themes installed are necessary, and if backups are being made. Think of it like your house. You know, if you call in a handyman because you don't know how to do something, he still needs the information from you, the person that lives in the house, in order to get his job done. It's the exact same with website cleanup. So that's the end of the webinar. If you have any other questions, feel free to tweet at us at Sucuri Security on Twitter and use the hashtag AskSucuri. Have a great day. Thank you.